Adjustment layers are a way for you to apply adjustments non-destructively to your photographs. This here shows a list of all of the adjustment layers that you have to work with. In this chapter, I'll be reviewing several of the adjustments you're most likely going to use for photographic editing. Here, you can see that the adjustments that are in blue are the ones that I'm going to be showing you throughout this chapter. As you can tell, I won't be going through every single adjustment. Instead, I'll be showing you only those that I feel are most helpful when editing photographs. Let's jump over to Photoshop to see how adjustment layers work. I have Photoshop open, and first I'm going to kind of review what I have set up here in the workspace. At the very top, I have the Adjustments panel open. Below that, I have the Properties panel. And then just below that is the Layers panel. These are the only three panels that I'll need to work with when applying adjustments to my photos. Adding an adjustment layer is as simple as clicking one of these options in the Adjustments panel. Simply click, and then if you look down in that Properties panel, you'll notice that it's changed a bit. The Properties panel is going to show you the properties of whichever layer you have selected. When you're working with adjustment layers, it's going to show that specific adjustment. Right now it's showing curves because I just added that to the Layers panel. If I were to add a second adjustment layer, if you notice down in the Layers panel, the photo filter adjustment is now highlighted and the properties have changed. If I go into that Layers panel and click on the curves adjustment, it's going to show me the properties for that layer. I'm going to go ahead and just highlight these two layers and delete them so we can kind of start over and I can show you some other ways that you can actually apply an adjustment layer. In the Layers panel, if you click on that half black and white circle, you'll see a pop-up of several adjustment layers. So basically anything that's starting from that brightness and contrast all the way down, those are going to be the same adjustment layers that you see in that Adjustments panel. You can also add adjustment layers through the menu. If you go up to Layer, New Adjustment Layer, then you have all of those options here as well. I'm going to go ahead and add a black and white adjustment. And when I do that from the menu option, you get a pop-up that you don't see with those other options. You can make changes to this if you want, such as adding a clipping mask. You can even add a color to that layer. It doesn't actually affect your image. It's just a way for you to kind of organize your layers if you have a lot of them going on. You can even change the blend mode and the opacity from here. But these options are also available in the Layers panel, so you don't have to worry about this if you're adding through the menu. Just go ahead and click OK. Over in the Properties panel, there are some options here at the bottom. The eyeball is going to toggle the visibility of that adjustment. You can also go into the Layers panel and click that eyeball on the left, which does the exact same thing. There are a few here that are grayed out, and that's because they are not quite applicable yet, but I'm going to show you how they work, and I just kind of have to set it up a bit. So I've added this black and white adjustment. I'm just going to make a few changes to some of the sliders here, so it's a little bit different than the default settings. So I'll increase that red slider. I'll make the greens a touch darker, and I'll try to make that sky a little bit darker as well. Now I can toggle the visibility of that layer, and the other two options next to it have become active. This option with the eyeball and the little curvy arrow allows you to toggle the previous state. As I press and hold that and then release, you'll see that it's toggling what was the previous state of that adjustment. And in this case, it's just the basic black and white adjustment. So if you want to get a feel for the kind of the changes that you've made along the way, then that's a good option to use. Otherwise, you're stuck with just toggling the full before and after. And if you want your image to be black and white, for example, that's not really going to tell you and show you what's changed in the photo. Now, if I were to make more adjustments to this, I'll just increase the yellows there, and I go back to that toggle state, it's still bringing me back to that original black and white adjustment. So if you're kind of playing with an adjustment layer and you want to see what different settings do, so maybe you've applied some settings and then you want to make changes, but kind of go back to that previous state of adjustments, what you'll want to do is go to the Layers panel and then click on a different layer, then go back to that adjustment. Now you can make those edits. And if I go back to that toggling of that previous state, it's going to show me what it looked like just before I clicked off of that adjustment. You can also reset all of the adjustments. That just takes them all the way back to their default. And here I just had to click it twice just to kind of go backwards a few steps. And you can also delete the adjustment layer from the Properties panel as well, just by using that little trash icon. So I'll go ahead and click that And now the adjustment layer is gone from my layers panel.